So one more type of servo is there, servo mechanism, which is known as duo servo. Now, what is this duo servo? Let us discuss this. In duo servo, now what happens? There is nothing like pivot. In duo servo, we uses an anchor. Now, what does this anchor do? These are your brake shoes. Now see, in duo servo action, this is your brake drum and these are your brake shoes. So what happens in duo servo, instead of making the shoes to be pivot, we uses a floating link that is attached at one of the end of the shoes, through which both the shoes are attached with each other. This is a floating rigid link. Okay, so what happens, on this side your wheel cylinder is there having a piston arrangement, and on this side one anchor pin is mounted. These are your return springs. Now what happens, this is anchor pin, these are your shoes, this is a floating link, this is a drum, and this is wheel cylinder. Okay, so what happens, as soon as this wheel cylinder gets the pressure from the brake fluid, this presses the brake shoes. So now one of the brake shoe is known as primary shoe and other one is known as secondary shoe in duo servo action. Okay, so what does this floating link help? It helps in transmission of force and motion. Transmission of motion and force from primary link to secondary link. Okay, or from secondary to primary in case of reverse braking. So what happens, as soon as these brake shoes move outwards, so this primary shoe will transfer its motion to the secondary shoe through this floating link. And this secondary shoe will transfer its motion to this anchor pin. Okay, this anchor pin actually helps in making both the shoes to rotate with the brake drum. Okay, so as soon as this motion and force is transmitted, so by the transmission of this force throughout the means in between the brake shoes, our braking force is increased. This helps in increasing the braking force and thus decreases pedal effort. So this was all about duo servo action. Okay, it uses a anchor pin and a floating link, floating rigid link. Now there are some of the properties of brake drum which we can discuss. First property is like that brake drum should be wear resistant. Okay, on rubbing it should not wear. Then second properties is like your brake drum should be hard enough to withstand harder braking, means it should be hard enough to withstand with the harder braking also. Then your brake drum should be heat resistant, so that this is the main property, so that it can withstand with high temperatures, okay, caused by the frictional force. Then your brake drum should be stiff, okay, and distortion resistant. These are some of the properties of brake drum. Okay, brake drum is usually made up of cast iron. Why cast iron? Because cast iron contains carbon, which prevents it contains carbon which prevents galling process. गैलिंग एंड सीजर. गैलिंग इज लाइक वेयर प्रॉपर्टी ओनली एंड सीजर मीन्स सीजिंग 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 ऑफ द ब्रेक ड्रम. सो मेनली कास्ट आयरन इज यूज टू मेक ब्रेक ड्रम. ओके एंड कास्ट आयरन ऑल्सो हैव अ प्रॉपर्टी दैट इट ओके सो कास्ट आयरन रेजिस्ट वार्पेज ऑल्सो. ओके सो दीज आर सम प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कास्ट आयरन विच इज यूज टू मेक ब्रेक ड्रम.